Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. My name is Zebunisa Khattak. I'm working in the Frontier Institute of Medical Sciences. कुछ ज़रूरी हदायत हैं. नंबर एक, आपके पास इंटरनेट की सहूलत मौजूद हो जिससे वीडियो डाउनलोड हो सके. आप लेक्चर को तवज्जो के साथ सुने और लेक्चर नोट अपने पास किया करें. नीचे मौजूद लिंक पर क्लिक करके आप इस लेक्चर को डाउनलोड कर सकते हैं. आखिर में दिए गए असाइनमेंट को हल करके आप कोऑर्डिनेटर को भेजवा दें. चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल आइकन पर जरूर क्लिक करें. घर पर रहें और महफूज रहें. सेहत अल्लाह की बहुत बड़ी नेमत है. शुक्रिया. इंट्रोडक्शन टू एप्टोमोलॉजी. द टर्म एप्टोमोलॉजी इज डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम द थ्री ग्रीक वर्ड्स एपी, डीमोस एंड लोगस. एपी मीन अपॉन और अमंग, वाइल डीमोस मीनिंग पीपल और पॉपुलेशन. लोगस इज द स्टडी और द स्टडी ऑफ साइंस. Thus, it is a science of events that occur, come upon or among in a community, the population. Epidemiology is the study of the disease frequency, disease distribution, determinants of health-related states and events in specified populations and the applications of this study to the control of health problems. This is the history and development of evolution. Epidemiology is very old word, dating back to 3rd century BC. Hippocrates, regarded as the father of clinical medicine, gave accurate description of syndromes on the basis of characteristics, symptoms and findings, attempting to explain disease occurrence from a rationale instead of a supernatural viewpoint. Is he entitled on airs, water and places? Environmental and host factors such as behavior might influence the development of disease. Another early contributor to epidemiology was John. He was the first to calculate the patterns of birth, death and disease occurrence, noting male-female disparities, high infant mortality, urban and rural differences and seasonal variations. Next, William Ferrer, the father of modern vital statistics and surveillance, developed many of the basic practices. There is a determinants of epidemiology, causes and other factors that has a great influence the occurrence of health related events. Health is in the center. Communities, families, societies and individuals, these are in the mid. Community is divided into three factors: human rights, biological, behavioral, while societies also divided in three parts: environmental, socio-economic, health system. Individuals are also divided into three parts: science and technology, aging of the population, socio-cultural. And families are also divided in three parts: equity and social justice, gender, information and communication. All these together are called the determinants of health. Reservoirs, habitat in which an infectious agent normally lives, grows and multiplies. Reservoirs include human, animal, environment and food. Case definition, a set of standard criteria for deciding whether a person has a particular disease or other health-related conditions. By using a standard case definition, we ensure that every case is diagnosed in the same way, regardless of when or where it occurred or who identified it. Portal of exit, the path by which an agent leaves the source host. The portal of exit usually corresponds to the site at which the agent is localized. Disease, pathology, changes in anatomy, physiology. Illness, feeling of not well. Sickness, unable to perform routine work. Impairment, loss of organ or function, disability, unable to perform function, handicapped, unable to perform job or service. Modes of transmission: direct transmission, direct person-to-person contact, indirect transmission, common vehicle, contaminated air, water supply, vector, mosquitoes, etc. Potential for disease transmission depends upon rate of growth of organisms, route by which it is transmitted from person to person. An infected individual can transmit common cold to a score of others in the course of an innocent hour in a crowded room. Determinants of disease outbreaks: herd immunity, incubation period, attack rate. Herd immunity: resistance of a group to an attack by a disease to which a large proportion of the members of the group are immune. Presence of a large immune proportion lessens the likelihood that a diseased person will come into contact with the susceptible individuals. Attack rate: there is a formula. Attack rate is equal to number of persons ill divided by number of persons at risk multiplied by 100. Incubation period: interval from receipt of infection to the time of onset of clinical illness. The person feels completely well and shows no signs of the disease. It may reflect the time needed for the organisms to replicate sufficiently until it reaches the critical mass needed for clinical disease to result. Incubation period: historical background. Vietnam Republic in 1377, Black Deaths. Rigosa detained travelers in isolated area for 30 days to see whether infection developed. Period was found insufficient as incubation period. Lengthened to 40 days, quarantine. Origin of the word quarantine: first legislation in the medical history. Quarantine: healthy person separated from community till incubation period. Isolation: diseased person separated from community till recovery. Latent period: time interval from exposure to a casual agent to onset of symptoms of disease. Time interval from exposure to an infectious agent until start of infectiousness. Time interval from exposure to an infection agent until detectable by laboratory test. Infectivity: ability of infectious agent to cause infection in a susceptible host. Pathogenicity: ability of an agent to cause observable disease after infection. Virulence: ability of infectious agent to cause severe disease measured by case fatality or death rate. Immunogenicity: ability of organism to produce immune response after infection, capable of providing protection against reinfection. Natural history: the progression of a disease process in an individual from the time the disease begins to the time it resolves in the absence of treatment. Endemic: habitual presence of a disease within a given geographical area, usual occurrence of a given disease within such area. Epidemics: significantly more cases of the same diseases than past experiences would have predicted for that place at that time among that population. Trade for investigation: word who, when, where, why. Time includes date of onset, place, dwelling, workplaces, person, age, sex, occupation. Epidemic curve: number of cases and time. This is the incubation period. Analysis: plot an epidemic curve, incubation period. Calculate attack rates, age, sex, occupation. Plot the geographical distribution by residence, workplace. Pandemic, worldwide epidemics. For example, COVID-19 we are facing now. This is a 2x2 table. This is the exposed persons and these are the non-exposed persons. Exposed persons are those persons in which disease are, while non-exposed persons are those persons which are not suffering from any kind of diseases. Exposed A and non-diseased B. A plus B. Non-exposed C. Diseased C and non-exposed and non-diseased D. This is C plus D. Diseased while A plus C, non-diseased B plus D. Risk, incidence, probability. Number who became ill divided by number who can become ill. Relative risk. Risk among exposed divided by risk among non-exposed is equal to A divided by A plus B, C divided by C plus D. RR is the abbreviation of relative risk. Relative risk is more than plus 1, exposure is causative. RR is less than plus 1, exposure is protective. If equal to plus 1, none effect of exposure. Attribute risk. Risk among exposed minus risk among non-exposed is equal to A divided by A plus B minus C divided by C plus D. Surveillance. Surveillance means monitoring. In a layman language, surveillance, ongoing systematic collection of health data, analysis of health data, interpretation of health data, essential to the planning, implementation and evaluation of public health practices, closely integrated with the timely dissemination of these data to those who need to know. Types of surveillance. Passive surveillance, available data on reportable disease, reporting responsibility, healthcare providers, EDO health. Active surveillance. Project staff make periodic visits to healthcare facilities. Passive surveillance, inexpensive, easy to develop initially, without additional funds or resources, filling reports as additional burden, view as peripheral to main responsibilities, local outbreaks are missed. Active surveillance, reporting more accurate, individuals specifically employed, local outbreaks are identified, more expensive, difficult to develop initially. Healthcare, prevention, treatment and management of illness and the preservation of mental and physical well-being through the services offered by the medical, nursing and allied health professionals. According to the World Health Organization, healthcare embraces all the goods and services designed to promote health, including preventive, curative, and palliative interventions, whether directed to individuals or to population. Healthcare. Healthcare level. There is three healthcare level. One is the primary healthcare level, prevention of occurrence of diseases. Secondary level, treatment of diseases and prevention of complications. And tertiary level healthcare, rehabilitation and treatment of complication. The Declaration of Almada, International Conference on the Primary Healthcare, was in Kazakhstan on dated 6 to 12 September 1978 and presented by 150 countries and represented by 150 countries. It expressed the need for urgent actions by all governments and the world community to protect and promote the health of all the people of the world. It was the first international declaration underlining that importance of primary health care. The primary health care approaches has since then been accepted by member countries of WHO as the key to achieving the goal of health for all, primary health care. Actually, primary health care is the essential health care based on practical, scientifically sound and socially acceptable methods and technology made universally accessible to individuals and families in the community through their full participation and at a cost that the community and the country can easily afford it to maintain at every stage of their development in the spirit of self-determination. There is elements of primary health care. We call it components of health care or functions of health care. Actually, these are education regarding health, simply health education, local endemics or epidemics, expanded program immunization or immunization, mother and child health and family planning, essential drugs provisions, nutrition, food, treatment of minor ailments, injuries, sanitation and safe water supply, additional components, health promotion, control of chronic diseases, vaccination against other diseases, reproductive health, food safety. These are the principles of primary health care. Community participation, equity, focus on prevention, multi-sectorial approach and appropriate technology. Additional principles, multi-agency collaboration and decentralization. Equity, principles of being fair to all, healthcare according to need rather than willingness to pay or ability to pay. Those with most health need should be provided with most care. Aims to address the current imbalance in healthcare by shifting the center of gravity from cities where a majority of the health budget is spent to rural areas where a majority of people live in most countries. Vertical equity and horizontal equity. Vertical equity, persons of unequal ability to pay make dissimilar payment. Horizontal equity, people of same ability to pay make same contribution regardless age, gender, marital status, occupation, place, residence. Community participation, there must be a continuing effort to secure meaningful involvement of the community in the planning, implementation and maintenance of health services besides maximum reliance on local resources such as manpower, money and material. Intersectorial coordination, primary health care involves, in addition to the health sector, all related sectors and aspects of national and community development, in particular agriculture, animal husbandry, food, industry, education, housing, public work, communication and other sectors. Appropriate technology, scientifically sound, adaptable to local needs, acceptable to those who apply it and for those for whom it is used, can be maintained by the people themselves in keeping with the principles of self-reliance with the resources the community and country can afford. Thank you.